Jimmy, when you take a look at that recent data, the inflation numbers for January, the preliminary GDP data, jobs report, does all of this equal the target range where the Bank of Canada feels comfortable to start cutting rates?
Yeah, right. We believe we are slowly but surely heading in that direction where the Bank of Canada will be comfortable delivering the first rate cuts. You know, we talked about the job market recently, which maybe was stronger than expected, but not nearly as strong such as to fit with the dizzying pace of population expansion. So in fact, you're seeing some slack building up in the labor market. So that's disinflationary. And, you know, we saw this number today with inflation coming in below expectations. But really, when you drill down, what you see is that the consumer categories, the clothing, the food, the airfares, those are coming down pretty sharply. And that's really what the Bank of Canada wants to see in terms of its response, in terms of the economy's response to its monetary policy. So we are seeing that. And I think by spring, the Bank of Canada will start to provide some respite.
I want to talk about that jobs picture because we have been hearing and seeing, you know, it seems more and more private companies are right across various sectors across Canada have been laying off workers. What does that jobs picture look like then for the balance of the year? Is it, you know, should we expect more to come?
Well, we're seeing some slack building up, that's for sure. And, you know, you're in a context right now where the job vacancy rate has pretty much returned to where it was pre-pandemic. And we continue to have a very strong pace of population expansion. So what that means is that you have more people looking for jobs at the minimum. And yes, you have some sectors, some industries where you are seeing some layoffs. So all that is consistent with a labor market that has been building more slack throughout 2023. And the evidence so far in 2024 is that this is continuing. And I think ultimately over time, and that's what we see in every cycle, is that it ends up breaking the persistence you see in wages, but with a certain lag. So I don't think this time is different on that front. We will see wages start to come down to reflect that, and that will provide the Bank of Canada with further confidence that it's time to cut rates.
When you take a look at recent earnings and the forecast for Walmart, a retail bellwether, or someone like Home Depot, who basically reflects what's happening in home construction or home improvements, what does that tell you about the economy and consumer spending?
Well, the consumer is clearly under pressure here. And we have to remember that when all this cycle is said and done in terms of the renewal, mortgage renewal cycle, the average Canadian will see an increase in payments in the order of 34%. When it comes to variable rate payments, it's 54%. So that's very significant. So you are seeing the surveys telling you that people are going to be cutting back on their spending. And they are doing so because when you look at consumption per capita, it's been down in Q2 and Q3 of last year. So, I mean, those companies, what they are seeing is the same thing that we are seeing when we look at the economic data. The consumer is under pressure. People are saving more as well in anticipation of the renewal period, in anticipation of having to increase their payments. And all those factors are really the playbook that Bank of Canada puts in place to see what exactly it's seen this morning, which is inflation in categories that are other than shelter coming down and coming down sufficiently to expect that the 2% target will be reached at the end of the year. And that's been our forecast.
We've been hearing of countries around the globe suggesting that they are in a technical recession, specifically most recently Japan and the UK. Where does our economy stand?
Well, that's going to be very interesting to watch on February 29th, because we are going to see the Canadian numbers for the fourth quarter. So far, we have preliminary data suggesting that the Canadian economy might have rebounded in the fourth quarter. It might have been assisted by the strength of the U.S. economy, because we've seen apparently a strong contribution from net exports. Having said that, we have to be very careful with the preliminary data, because there is a history of significant revisions to the StatsCan data. And sometimes the data that ultimately is published departs from the preliminary indication. So we are being careful. What we've seen in Japan and in the UK, it's not that the probability of that happening here is zero. But you know, even that being said, we know that the circumstances here are one where we have near record population expansion. So that will, even if mechanically, produce a stronger GDP. But when you look at things on a per capita basis, the Canadian economy is, for all intents and purposes, is in recession.
Is it a wait and see what the Federal Reserve does when it comes to what central banks do next?
I don't think the Federal Reserve is in the same spot as the Bank of Canada is. And the reason for that is that the U.S. economy is coming off a 2023 year that's been spectacular by, all stretches of imagination. All the numbers have defied expectations, leading indicators, and even the Fed has been surprised by the strength. So what that means is that the Fed has more margin for error in terms of keeping rates higher for longer if it has to, rather than in Canada, where we are seeing the damage caused by that very aggressive monetary policy. And also you're seeing inflation come down as you would have expected it. So I think given the fact that our economy is much more sensitive to interest rates, and if the Bank of Canada really wants to mitigate the risk of generating a very severe recession, unlike the Fed, where you do have some momentum, I think it's time to cut rates, and the Bank of Canada has the latitude to do it before the Fed.
And lastly, you had mentioned that that first rate cut might come in around mid-year. What is Desjardins' forecast?
Right. So our forecast as of now is June for the first rate cut. But obviously, if we see further numbers that surprise positively in terms of the inflation or in terms of economic slowdown, it could easily be April. And we have the markets kind of half and half right now between April and June. But, after that, we expect the Bank of Canada to deliver 25 basis point rate cuts at every meeting and into 2025. By the end of 2025, rates should be roughly half where they are now, which will help the economy recover without a very significant recession, even if 2025 is going to remain a challenging year, especially when it comes to mortgage renewals.